autism. Now, basically, autism is also known as a complex development disability.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a very special guest today, right here with us.
Absolutely.
His name is Muhammad Saifuddin.
Excellent. Muhammad Saifuddin, welcome to the show, of course, accompanied by his mother, Wan Hayati. Now, something special about this boy. He just scored 9 A's in his SPM. Even I didn't score 9 A's in my SPM. You have put me to shame. What is your secret? That's what we want to know.
Just making sure that I understand as much as possible.
And then that's it? That's your secret?
That's it, really.
My goodness, where were you? Why didn't you coach me when I was taking my SPM?
Which school did you go to?
Yeah, SMK Dato' Mtari Dalam.
And and speak to Puan Hayati as well. And the condition called Asperger's. Yeah, maybe some of our audience who are not familiar with it. It's part of the spectrum of autism, is it not?
It is in the high functioning autism, meaning that he has problems mostly only on the social skills, communications, understanding emotion. But study wise, he's alright.
I see. So when did this condition start to manifest itself?
At what age did you realize that he was? I suppose it started like very early, when he was a toddler probably. It is just that, as a mother, well, I was ignorant then, the signs were all there, but I just didn't know, because he was so bright, he learned very easily, he had so many interests in so many things, and I didn't know that was a sign of Asperger's syndrome. So it was rather late that we started to get help for him. Were there any challenges at all? Raising him when he was at home, he was a very pleasant boy, no problems at all. He was very much into his own. He likes to do things at home, playing with his toys, reading, lots of reading. It just started when he went to primary school, and then when I started to notice him, there's problems. He had problems fitting in. The other students didn't understand him. But then again, I thought that was most probably just because my way of bringing him up. He was the first child, and probably that's why he was so much into himself.
So was there a lot of blaming yourselves as parents? I mean, that does happen, yeah?
Yes, of course, yes. Because as a parent, as a mother, I should have known from very early, and should have gotten help for him very, very early. But we just started when he was in Form 1.
But there's no one to blame, of course, yeah? There's definitely no one to blame, and especially for the awareness of Asperger's.
Because in general, not many people are aware of autism itself. Yeah, and April is Autism Awareness Month.
Exactly. And of course, this is our tribute to World Autism Day. It was yesterday, actually. Alright, and let's speak a little bit to Saifuddin as well. Some of your subjects in school, what's your favorite?
None of them, really.
Really?
None of them.
So you love all of them?
Or maybe
equally.
If you have a certain subject that you're really good at.
I've been really good at mathematics. I think it's rather simple compared to additional math.
Were you in a science stream?
Yes, science stream.
Definitely, you're doing additional math. So, what do you want to be when you grow up? Have you thought about it?
I have thought about it, and not many. I can't really be sure what is it that I want to do for a living. It's hard to be sure about that.
But do you have a rough idea of, okay, what do you want to do after school?
Take A-levels, probably.
Oh, he's got a plan already. And how does it feel like to be looked upon by your peers with respect? Everyone's looking up to you. Wow, you got 9 A's. How does it feel?
I'm not sure. I haven't seen them since since school ended, except for the day I took my results. I haven't really seen anyone from school since then.
I see.
Well, actually, I did see them once, but only saw. Didn't really talk.
Are you the eldest? How many siblings do you have?
Four, including myself, four. Everyone, the other three are younger than me.
Abang Sulung, eh?
Yeah.
Alright, so how does it feel like filling in the shoes of Abang Sulung and looking after your siblings?
Not very easy.
Are they very naughty?
My youngest brother is a bit overly active when he's for someone who's indoors most of the time.
Alright.
That's tricky.
Alright. But when it comes to extracurricular activities though, are you very active?
No.
No? Alright. Okay.
He attends every extracurricular meeting. He takes part in competitions that he can. For example, he took part in the Star Mighty Minds for 2 years, Form 4 and Form 5.
Yeah,
and when he was in Form 5, then, his group managed to get 5th place for the Johor State level.
Well done.
Very good. So you're quite a high achiever as well. The thing is, okay, you have a general idea of what you want to be, what you want to do when you grow up. Would you like to help people who suffer from the same condition?
I don't know, that sounds like something I'd like to do, but I don't know if I can actually do that.
Mm-hmm. What's stopping you?
Social sciences is just not something I don't really understand very well.
If that's quite amazing actually for someone his age to actually understand his limitations as well.
Very aware.
When he was waiting for his results, he met a few people, especially he went to see Dr. Hasnaturan from UKM. They talked and he was really into trying to see if he could do psychology, you know, help people with autism. But many were saying that since he has problem understanding people, probably he should put that aside first lah. Think about it.
I see. As far as we've done some research as well, Asperger syndrome does get better as you grow older.
Hopefully yes.
Yeah.
Has it, somewhat improved from the first time you discovered that he has autism?
Probably he understands people more, but it is still a struggle actually.
Well, how about parents out there? What would you advise them, especially if they have symptoms, their kid is extremely bright, but having problems with social interaction, and when it starts manifesting, what should they do?
They should get help lah. Now that we are, since this month is Autism Awareness Month, there'll be many programs on TV, different channels, so parents should pay attention. And because he was so bright, so we really didn't think that there was any problems. But if you see any problems at all in whatever areas, you should try and get help and ask people. There are people out there who knows.
Is there any maybe symptoms to first detect when you first detected his
condition?
Maybe it's something that you could hint to the parents.
He had difficulties in school. He was different and people couldn't accept him for being different. Things like nerds and weirdos, things like that.
How was he reacting back then to all these comments?
Was there any bullying as well?
Mostly teasing. I know people go out of their way to make me angry.
Really? I mean, kids are kids. Sometimes it can be really immature, and I think you're really a bit above all that. But how do you handle it initially?
Mostly by getting angry.
That was initially, and how do you handle it now?
Not very differently.
Not very differently, yeah. So of course, sometimes irresponsible people rile you up really easy, yeah. All right, and did you have difficulties handling that particular period in his life where kids?
Yes, of course. As a parent, when he was in primary, he was on his own. I was very close to the school. I was at any school activities, me and his father would take part. And then we entered secondary. I was very worried because the secondary schools are big. So I managed to get a transfer to the school where he was put in. So things got much better then. So all the teachers there, they became my eyes and ears. They understood better. They tried to understand. And it's really, congratulations to the teachers. The teachers in the mainstream, they're not trained at all to teach students with us with the special needs, but out of their sincerity, they tried very hard, and yes, alhamdulillah, he managed to score for his SPM.
The effort is there,
yes.
In terms of our system as well, do you feel better mechanisms should be in place, or special teachers trained, especially to handle people with potential, such as yourself?
Yes, of course. One thing is that I'm a teacher too, so we were not trained at all under special needs, at least during my time. So we have been suggesting that for mainstream teachers, they should also take this special education needs as one of their core subjects during their course, because they do come across such students, and when we don't know, we would think that these students has problem with discipline, this student is just being lazy, or sometimes he sleeps in class, and sometimes he really can't understand, and he keeps asking, other kids to find that irritating, because they don't want the teacher to keep giving attention, focusing on him, answering his questions. But the teachers, they know, and they will say things like, we will discuss after this, yes. The teachers should be aware of all this so that they can help such students.
Of course, what we're afraid of is teachers who don't understand and give unnecessary pressure. to kids with special needs.
That's why parents, if you have special kids like this, you need to work closely with the school. Mm-hmm. And once the teachers understand this, being teachers, they are there to help.
Mm-hmm. Let me ask for this. Your mom has been with you and your dad as well every step of the way.
Maybe not every step.
Not literally, of course. Maybe there for you, of course. And how do you feel about that?
Thankful, I guess, because my father can do that even though he doesn't actually live with me.
But he does keep your best interest at heart, so yeah.
He's reliable to come for the parent-teacher things at school. Some parents, even the ones that don't live far away, have trouble doing that.
Exactly.
So your parents are very committed.
Yeah, when he has things like camping or not going for competitions or school trips, the father will try to be there to go with him.
All right, excellent. I hope it's not too much to ask. What would you like to say to viewers out there? And of course, maybe they have a son or a nephew or a family member that has Asperger's like yourself. What would you like to say to them?
I'm not really sure.
You do realize you're a very inspiring figure to many kids out there.
That is odd.
Oh, that's so.
Or maybe an advice to you, younger kids at school, having trouble studying.
Stay in school.
I don't really know. I'm not even sure if what I did was best.
Well, you've got 9 A's. That's for sure. What you do with your 9 A's?
Apply for something, probably.
And I really hope I'll see you again, and I really hope you'll be in a position where I can say doctor or engineer.
I don't think I want to be an engineer. Technical sciences are hard for me.
Do you know that many kids your age don't even know what they want? You know, and the fact that you already know what you are good at and what you're not good at, it really puts you miles ahead of many people out there.
Right, some people only come to about age 27 to figure out what they want.
Yeah, some people still don't care. But I think, of course, this is a testament to the human spirit. And thank you so much for the love you've shown and to see your son develop to his full potential. What would you like to say to parents?
Just be there for them, try to understand, and you know, just be aware and get help when you're not alone. There are many people out there who will help, for example. I hope I'm not wrong saying this. We have Facebook group called Autism Malaysia, and I've learned a lot from them, and every member there is very helpful. So we have lots of social media, like the social networking, which can help from these teachers.
All right, are you on Facebook?
No.
Oh no.
I used to be, but apparently I discovered that I had 2 accounts.
Oh, okay.
Well, I was using 2 to test stuff, but apparently you're not allowed to have more than 1 account. I think there's some fear of people pretending to be other
identity
people.
Identity theft, absolutely, yes. It's basically safe out there.
The website thought that one of them was not me.
Ah, I see. Well, you better be careful out there. I will look out for you on Facebook.
But it's not there anymore.
It's not there anymore.
The accounts are not there anymore.
Well, we hope you get a new one very, very soon so I can be your friend.
Thank you so much, Sakudin. Thank you very much for having us. We wish you the best of luck in your future undertakings.
Right.
Okay, we get to take 2, but coming up next on The Breakfast Show.
Interesting stuff indeed.
Just having a moment.